about virtual learning today. And anyone can tell about the meaning of virtual learning? What is virtual learning? Govinda ji, can you share something about virtual learning?
My opinion, virtual learning is that environment in which the participant with the computer with ICT-based tools
will
take part in the interaction. It's two-way communication.
Two-way communication using technology, yeah? The two-way communication is extremely used and for making the relationship and constructing knowledge, for making great collaboration. That is virtual learning. And this regard, technological support is most important. Are you clear?
Yes.
And virtual learning is learning experiences. It is learning experiences that is enhanced through the utilizing computer and then internet both outside and inside. A confident internet based technology is most important. And to use the technology, internet technology, we should have a technological tools like mobile phone and computer as well. They can be used for in outside and inside the classroom for global communication. And instruction most commonly takes place in the online environment. Now all the instruction and suggestion and advice and the instruction given and through the online process. Not meeting physically, and there's no physical presence, right? And the teaching activity are carried out online. And all the activity, and pedagogical activity, and analysis activity are carried out in the online process. And where teacher and learners are physically affiliated. And the teacher and the students are working and same platform, but they are away from each other. And physically, they are way away, and the short way to virtual learning. So, remote access to unlimited areas and with educational and services and topic tutor offered worldwide. That is kind of unlimited educational program. It has been extended around the world. And all the participants can do the same task together, making collaboration. That is virtual learning. And the individualized learning process that takes into the consideration a personal level of competence, individualness, and then different learning style. Because in virtual learning, we can find different types of students. Different type of learners are there. They can use different type of learning strategy. And regards, they are information from other person. And then safe and secure learning environment. The environment is very secure and very confidential and more secure and more comfortable as well. Because learners are automatically motivated and to learn new things, and there is no high pressure. There is high motivation to students, even from the environment teacher as well. Flexible learning in terms of time, location and pace. Learning very flexible means anytime, anywhere, any device. Suppose you are traveling, bus going somewhere, you are learning something using the laptop and mobile phone and using technology, And cost effectiveness in time effectiveness easily, scale and much more. And cost is a very customized, low pace. And there's no need to worry about being the class in high time by traveling long distances. And you have to stay at home, and connect your internet and certain portal at the same time. And enter the class of participation in test. That is virtual learning. And then this type of virtual learning, and regarding virtual learning, we could talk about important matter. What are they? E-learning, can you tell us e-learning? It is one part of the technological learning, e-learning, web-based learnings, it is learnings. All the time, learners are participating and instructor engage all the time, and using all the time. And go on the web browser. It's like www.edx.org. This is a great platform. And if you log in there and browsing process, you can find thousands of information one time. And which is better for you, which is required for you, select one and go in learnings and deep process. Okay. And then online learnings will same time, because online has been categorized in two patterns, and asynchronous online and synchronous online. And face to face and direct communication, not face to face, communicating using technology. And we can give feedback after a long time, after some time. In synchronous learning and frequent communication, frequent interaction is happening, yes, between teacher student and student teacher to teacher. And distance learning can be modified and corresponding learning and e-learning and mobile learnings and online learnings and e-learning as well. In the past, we had corresponding learning. And we have, there is no e-materials, and published material was delivered to the candidate, to the participant, and through the mail, to the post office. That kind of distance learning. But distance learning has been modified and accepted in e-learning process. And blended learning. Blend means the two things are conjugated together. One is the teacher's aspect, other is another thing, and explore from the learners. This is the computer. The learners are doing something by sourcing different information to the computer. The teacher are here and supporting him. And the two ideas will be integrated together, that is the blended learning. Because teacher's emotion, teacher's sentiment, teacher's opinions, and the ideas what given in blended on the website will be integrated and merged together. A new idea will be constructed, generated. That is the blended learning. Blend means joint learning. Okay? And summary of virtual learning. Actually, I would like to say that the summary of the virtual learning. Virtual learning combine all the above mentioned terms. What we mentioned before, just like web-based learnings, and then e-learnings, and then distance learnings are combined together, they are the virtual learning. And it can overcome many but drawback of physical environment. There's no physical environment, there's a drawback. They don't find the physical environment. Every environment covered from technology. So, and just facilitate location. Online environment allow teacher to work with large number of students and optimize their routine afterwards. Because one teacher can do a lot of the students together, once time more than, if you are going to MOOC program, yes, massive open online course, one teacher work with 1,000 students together, once time. That's why the maximum utilization of the time and then learns together. And then virtual learning also bring a new pedagogical technique in the transition programs, because virtual learning bring a new type of pedagogical aspect into the learning process, and then overcoming the transition type of pedagogical, yes, aspect. In such ways, and time learning is more personalized and convenient. Learning are automatically motivated by themselves. The learners automatically motivated and to learn something, there is no high pressure. They know about the meaning of learning on receive, and then situation is very convenient, very comfortable, and very easy. Are you clear? Are you clear?
Yes,
any question about virtual learning? Can you tell about the type of the virtual learning?
So what is the difference between e-learning and online learning?
Yes. Yes, e-learning and e-learning and online learning. Yes? E-learning is kind of, yes. Online learning are categorized two patterns, and synchronized and asynchronized. E-learning means learning, there is no hard copy, no published materials. You can find all the materials and digital format. If you go on the website and learning something individually, it is e-learning. But in online learnings and synchronized learning, asynchronous learning most important. But that's why e-learning covers the online learnings. Online learning has been playing with e-learning. Okay? That's
right.
Yeah.
Could you please elaborate web-based learning?
Okay, very nice question. Web-based means if you go on the www.edh.org, you can find the website of, you can find the about information about Harvard and Berkeley and Massachusetts University worlds. And what about what program they are offering around the world? You can find lot of information by browsing and for surfing internet. Okay? And in this regard, there is no way and Google searching. Just click just browse website www.edh.org and find the lot of the SQL suits, and you can find their objective and profile and their program and the scholastic person and what their type program, what a passive to the newcomer and the entrance student, and what a pedagogical yes and practice of the year, what is learning and teaching strategy, and cut it out in class, yes, what is distance and learning process. This all the information will be taken from the participant and the student and teacher as well. That is web-based learning.
Thank you, sir.
Any question? Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Very nice to you, active participation. I'm so much happy with you. And I hope that just to come, I'll find the same situation.
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
उसको गुगल प्ले स्टोरबाट